I bought it. I've modified it considerably, though. The original one didn't work very good, to tell you the truth. The guys sold lots of them. I'm probably not the only guy who's modified it. And it was brutally cumbersome to carry around.
Start out in a ready position after every shot. back to here and push right up to the ball. You want to feel like you're pushing over the ball. That was better. Your racket should end up right up over your shoulder. Yeah. Don't worry about where it's going. Just work on the stroke.
I knock it off in my face.
I'm alright.
Just let me
rip it. Thumb can't be on top.
Oh, nice.
Wait, your hand's usually right on the end?
Usually.
Yeah, you don't want your thumb up. That's a squash thing. Try this. Now I'm going to add a little variation to this that I've never tried before. The trick is going to be, don't let that cut you. It doesn't need to be right at the end. You just want to get the feel of that, not flicking. Mm-hmm. The flicking is killing you. So, this knuckle should be on number three. One, two, three. Right. Thumb right down beside, like that. Trigger finger. All right.
Thank you.
left leg.
Yeah, don't get there and stop. Keep pushing up through it. That's going to get it.
Thank you.
grab some water. So, backhand is really just the reverse of the forehand, except you're going to use two hands. So, the footwork's the same. We're going to get set with the back foot. Now, we want our knuckle up on top, on number one. Two hands together, put your other hand there.
Yeah.
So, move it on top, not so much there, but there. You want it tight. You don't want it a gap, and you don't want it here, because what'll happen there is you'll snap it up. Right? So we want it here, elbows a little bit out. Out. Elbows? Yes. So imagine this is right in front of you. Put the racket right in front of you. There. Now extend it out a little bit. There. And the reason we want to do that is that if we get a bad bounce, we can pull it in and still make a shot. Or stretch it out and still make a shot. But if we lock our elbows, we can't make that adjustment at the last second. Now, that's too much. Yeah, well, here's one. So, yeah, that's too much. Move it back there. Yeah, let's put it on two. So there's the racket right in front of you. And when I move the racket, your shoulders and hips should move. This is just, that's it, right there. So watch. So I'm here, set up. I'm gonna step out. My shoulder, I haven't rotated my body. Now I've rotated my body, and I never break my wrists. My wrists are locked there. Even all the way up here, I still keep my wrist locked. So think of that wrist straight. If you do that, you have no strength. If you do that, you have no strength. Any of those other positions, the only time we really have strength in our wrist is when it's straight. See, it's really the only way we can lock it consistently. So it's there, racket head below our wrist, contact, finish up over our shoulder. So let's just do what we call shadow swings with a few of those. Check your grip. And roll this hand over just a little bit more, because we don't want to be flicking this up. We want to get that racket head below our wrist at contact. So step out. Alright, so you're here. So I want to get you there.
If I'm turning it more,
Don't worry about that. If it's back, if it's slightly face down at here, at contact, now the problem you're going to have here is that you keep leaning back. And I want you to see where my weight is. I've got a nice straight line, but my weight is way past my knee. You can't be here, because as soon as you do this, every ball is going high. Get that shoulder here, get the weight past the knee. Yeah, there. There's your contact point. And release the elbows up over the shoulder. Do a couple. Right. Same thing. Right. Good. So let's try, we'll drop the ball first. So put your left foot on the line here, right here at the corner. So what I'm going to do is judge your step. Get that foot back. Yeah. So you want your weight forward. There. Right. And all we want to do is get it over the net. So as soon as I drop it, watch.
I don't know how I'm supposed to step. If I step.
No, then. That's what I'm going to judge. Foot back, yeah. Well, I really want you stepping that way, not this way. If your weight is stepping this way, where is your power going? Against the direction of where you want. You want to step towards your target. So if you're here and you want to go cross court, you step here. If you want to go down the line, you step there.
So
here I'm crossed over. Here I'm not really crossed over. I'm right in line. My power is going that way. I never really want my weight going that way because then I'm not using any of my weight into the ball. Okay. So we're here, step, contact. Okay. See how my weight is going towards my target? So let's just do one more step. Right? The weight's still going this way. So imagine you're going to step to there. Right. Without rotating your shoulders first. So foot back. So right foot back, yeah. Step. There. That's perfect. That's perfect. Let's do it again. Step to the target. Perfect. Okay. So come down back this way, just a little closer. Now, what you're going to find is that if you turn that heel in, your hips are already here. And we want your hips like this, square, parallel to the fence. Yeah. And hips square. Well, no, that's just get your hips. Now, so move that toe out wider. That's fine. But what we don't want is you there, because when you've done that, you're overcommitted, right?
I don't have no balance on it.
No.
I'm all like,
yeah. Well,
like
I want this foot out here. There.
Put my knee in.
No. Imagine you were running and you stopped, because that's what you're going to do. You run and you stop. You wouldn't go like this when you stop. You wouldn't move that heel in like this. Because, and I'll tell you, and I'm being nitpicky here, but there's a reason, because if you want to go down the line, and your hips are here, and you step here, you've got no weight going in that direction. And you're going to have a hard time keeping that ball on the target. If you step here, my hips are still square, now I make contact, push.
What if I'm standing waiting?
Yeah.
Then have to turn.
You're going to have to do that every time. Yeah. Well, so here's what it looks like. So I'm in my ready position. Just back up a bit. Stop. Here. So I've stopped. And I'm ready. And I'm looking out over my shoulder. And I'm looking to where my opponent is going. Because if he goes that way, I'm going to go behind him down the line. So then I step here. Make contact here. Even with my front foot. That ball will go down the line. Stop. I'm here. Now he stays in the forehand corner. I want to go cross court. I'm going to step here. Catch the ball out front of my front foot. Here's my contact point. Push it. I never really want to be stepping that way. Right? But if I'm here, I can go either way. And that's the beauty of both the forehand and the backhand. The forehand is exactly the same. Run, set. At this point, you don't know where I'm going. Right? I can go either way. My shoulders are parallel to the fence. My hips are parallel to the fence. If I want to go down the line, I go here, contact, there. If I want to go cross court, I step here, contact, there. So, right here, you step, contact, finish. But, so, imagine you just ran and you stopped. And you're looking out because you haven't decided where you're going to go yet. And at this point you haven't, because you're waiting to see what your opponent's going to do while the ball's in the air. If you're here when the ball bounces, you have lots of time. Where most people get in trouble is they get to the ball late, and then they do this. Who knows where it's going? Set, hit. Heel, yeah, both and that one a little wider so that you're comfortable. Nice balance. Just go a little more weight forward. Right. Yeah. It's going to take me a few to figure out. Put your foot on the line. Nice and square. Too close. So, get that foot a little wider so that you're solid. And you're right. You need to be on balance. Because you're going to step to that ball. Good. And that's better because at least you're stepping in the right direction now. And you're not going to make this mistake because you're going to be figuring out where the bounce of the ball is. Perfect. Yeah. So you don't want to get caught out here because now you have no strength. When you get out to here, you have no push left. You want those hands in front of you, there, not out here. Too far. Beautiful. Absolutely perfect. Come back this way. It's all right. We're not worried about the results at this point. Racket head down. No? When I say racket head down, I mean below your wrist. You have on both of your shots, you have a tendency to snap it up like this, and that's why you're not making good contact. Keep that racket head below your wrist. I drop it, you've got to be stepping. Set. So. That's alright. Yeah, that's alright. So with this hand, I want you to go flat like this. Perfectly flat with the thumb beside it. Thumb beside. Imagine it's just like that. And this is, you're gonna push right there. Leave it flat, right through the stroke. Because that's all that hand does, push. It doesn't push up, it just pushes through the back. Flat. Thumb down. Put your thumb down. So, don't get it there. Just underneath that part of your hand. Because that's where it's going to be. It's going to be there. What I want you to get used to is all this hand does, it's just, in many ways, this is just like golf. All this backhand does is push up through the ball. It doesn't flick. It doesn't change the direction. You don't need it to put spin on it. Lower on your hand, on the back hand, yeah, there. Get it right in the palm, because when you wrap the fingers around, it will feel exactly the same. Okay, so now do it. Yeah. Yes, because you're getting it too close to your body. So let's do the same thing. Leave your foot on the line. That foot shouldn't move. Spring. Just uncoiling the spring. Okay, so put it on. Put it on now. What I don't want to see is this. I want you to keep that racket head. Like, when I'm hitting shots, I am literally hitting shots like this. I'm rolling the ball down the length. There's no requirement to roll the ball down here. We think we have to do that to get spin, and we don't. Change that, then I'm out of sync in terms of where I'm bouncing the ball. Okay, I'm trying to get you to step out further without using your wrist. Use two hands. You can reach out this far with two hands. All the way through with that back hand, even out here. Yeah, that's fine. Good. Some of this is just finding your contact right there. As soon as you do this with the backhand, that's over the fence. And that's because you broke the front wrist. If you learn to lock that front wrist, you can't do that. That's a killer shot. Just lock your right hand wrist. You can't move. Direction's good. Just gotta get a little more height. Okay. That's the one. over my head. That should be the right height to get a deep ball. First day of Chinese. Be patient. Good. That hurt. Somewhere in between those two. Oh.
This one, I don't like this.
That means you can get every ball in. What you have a problem with is you have no concept of between that and full speed. And you've got to back it down. Nobody learns to play the piano like a virtuoso in 10 minutes, right? So some of this is you've got to be patient with yourself and learn to incrementally speed that up. So those last bunch, you put every ball in play. So do it 20% harder than that, not 100% harder. Yeah, so don't stop swinging. Same swing, just a little bit harder. There. So that was in between. That's good. Yeah.
Can't hit it with the strings though, but it's only going off here.
First day of Chinese. You're only going, if you put five balls out of, if you do 2 out of 10 today, in the court, to be lucky. On the back end, it's a new skill. Left hand is not in the right position. Yeah.
recreational level, the fourth shot wins. You don't, almost no rally goes past four shots. So all you gotta do is get three in a row in. Just focus on getting your hands. Let's do the set hit thing again, because that really helps.